Good morning to all of you. So today we are going to discuss the remaining half part of the chapter, and the chapter name is Sectors of the Indian Economy. Okay, so we are going to discuss the remaining half part. I hope already the first part that we have discussed, it is understood by all the students. So today we are going to we are starting with the page number 27. Just go through that in the PDF, or if you have the book, just go through that. We are starting with the page number 27, and the topic is how to create more employment. Okay, last time we have discussed about the disguised unemployment and underemployment situations in the India. So now the topic is how to create more employment is basically the government has to think about it, how we can increase the employment. The situation is very tough now at present. During this particular COVID-19 period, the government is also trying to find out the best solution to provide the employment to the rural people or the laborers, those who migrated from another place, okay, and they came to their local places. So we just have to think about the employment of them. We take an example which is already given in our book. Okay, this example is like, take a case of Lakshmi with her 2-sector plot of unirrigated land. There is a lady called Lakshmi, and she is having an 2-hectare plot of unirrigated land. So how we can provide the employment? Suppose she do not have any irrigation facility on her land. So what government can do? Government can provide loan to her so that she can buy some irrigation facility, she can buy some seeds and all this, and she can grow some like wheat and all this on her land. So basically through this she is going to provide a employment to other people. Okay, some people she will call to other people to work on her land. Okay, so these are some activities through which the government can provide the loans and some benefits to the rural poor people, so that they will get employment and they will also generate employment for others. Okay, this is all about this particular case. Just go through this. Okay, here you can find it out another example. Okay, next, a study here, just go through that. A study conducted by the Planning Commission. Okay, a study conducted by the Planning Commission. Planning Commission is what? Planning Commission at present, now the name has been changed, and what is called Niti Aayog. Okay, Niti Aayog is the name, and this Planning Commission is chaired by the Prime Minister. Okay, and what is the work of this Planning Commission or Niti Aayog? The work is that they are making 5 years plan for the whole country. In the next 5 years, how much they are going to expense, they are going to do some kind of expenditures in the country, and what kind of revenues they are going to get. So this all the things they are planning in this. So basically what they have estimated, that nearly 20 lakhs jobs can be created in the education sector alone. 20 lakhs jobs can be created in the education sector alone. So we need to identify the sectors so that we can create some new jobs in any different kind of fields. One more thing we are going to discuss in this, this is MNREGA scheme. You have heard now at this particular time, during this coronavirus period, government is providing the work to the laborers, those who has migrated from their workplace to the their local place. Okay, so government is now ready to provide them a particular job in the scheme of MNREGA. MNREGA is what? Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, and this act was established in 2005. In 2005 the name was NREGA only. MNREGA was implemented in 2006. Here in the book it is only given 2005. Okay, make a note, 2006 is the MNREGA and NREGA was 2005, same. So NREGA is changed to MNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, what is this particular scheme? This particular schemes is providing in that the person, those who are registered in this, they are getting 100 days 100 days guaranteed employment during a year. If government fails to provide them this 100 days employment, the government has to pay the minimum per day wages to them without any work. Okay, so government has a plan to give 100 days works to the people out of 365 days. Okay, so this is, let's work out this. These are the questions, just go through that and complete it. Okay, thank you.